Spiegel, over the weekend, you went to a bris. Our good friend Darren Kadish, an Iraq attorney general, had a child. Harry. Harry is now a member of this world, and we had the bris, the circumcision ceremony over the weekend. We talked about it, and we had a lot of questions. I'm going to let you bring in our next guest because I have no idea. I don't want to butcher any kind of name or
anything.
I've never
talked to this person before, but he...
He reached out to us.
Yeah, he emailed us. He said he lives in Israel.
Wow.
And how did he hear about it?
That's cool.
He listens in Israel.
Get out of here, man.
Yeah, you could listen to the show outside of Baltimore.
We got Moyles in the motherland.
I didn't know that.
Anywhere in the world, baby.
Rabbi Hayum Leiter, or is it Leiter?
You're making me sound a little Arab here. Can we back it up a notch?
Okay.
Please.
My name's Chaim, like in Fiddler on the Roof. L'chaim.
You know, Chaim. Oh, well, it says here H-A-V-I-M. Is that incorrect?
No, they lopped off the Y. It's a Y.
God. You know, I'm so embarrassed.
Chaim Leiter.
All right. I didn't do the intro.
Moyle Chaim Leiter.
Rabbi Leiter. Okay, so what made you contact us?
Well, I just heard a lot of what you guys were talking about yesterday. Truth be told, I try hard to listen outside of America, but it just came up because you guys posted it on your website, and I'm always trolling the old internet for things about circumcision because that's my business.
Ditto.
Sounds normal.
And that's very normal for me. Not everybody in the world, but it's normal for me. Anyway, so I listened to what you guys had to say, and I just was like, you know, there was a couple of things you guys were talking about. You really didn't know what the issues were. I wanted to help you out if you needed some help.
Rabbi, and I have to say this before we get into the discussion about the bris and the circumcision and all that. This is just my own projection. When I think of a moel, I think of a rabbi, I think of a Jewish wise man. I always imagine someone that sounds and appears older. You sound like a younger man. Do you mind me asking how old you are?
No, I don't mind at all. I am 39 years old.
Okay, there you go. All right.
So, you know, I consider myself wise, but, you know, to each his own. I work here in Israel actually teaching people all sorts of things about Judaism at a wonderful place called Pardes when they come to learn and study. And then when I get britzot, when I get a bris, I go and I do a bris.
Wow. So you're calling, where are you calling from right now?
Jerusalem.
Jerusalem, Israel.
That's it.
That's cool, amazing. Man. That's so cool. And I still am a little confused as to how you found the video yesterday.
What are penises?
Something was on your website. I don't know who put this up on your website, but it's Sitch.
Yeah, but why are you on our website is my question, I guess. Why are you on our website?
Back it up.
Yeah.
I get Google alert notifications. Whenever circumcision goes over the web, I get it.
So anytime the word circumcision gets broadcast on the web, you can alert to your phone.
Yes.
Wow.
Let me put two things out there. There's an awful lot of circumcision in Africa right now, and there's an awful lot of female circumcision out there. And I'm not as interested in those two things.
Right. So a lot of that gets through the filter. Yeah, like I've got Asian massage set up. So whenever some new location opens up, I get a little alert, and you get one about circumcision. Were you a fan of the show at all prior to this? Have you ever listened to our show
before? Absolutely never heard of you guys in my life.
Just got an alert.
I
got an alert, and I said, you know what? People need to know about circumcision, so this is why I'm here.
Crazy. Yeah, I guess the world works in mysterious ways. So what did you hear in our segment that maybe we... go ahead.
One of the big things that you guys brought up, there's been a lot of controversy in New York about this thing called mitzitza. Right? You guys were talking about that a little bit yesterday?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Right. So mitzitza is a very complicated, both emotionally... physically, everything about it, I think everyone who's in the modern spectrum, as we like to call them, there are people in the Jewish world who are not in the modern spectrum, but those that are in the modern spectrum struggle with this issue. And those in the modern spectrum have tried, I should say the most of them, have tried desperately not to do what's happening in New York, which is there's actually physical contact between the mouth of the moyle and the cut. Let's kind of try and keep it as clean as possible.
Right. There was a tradition where the moyle would, if you get a cut, you can, like, suck the blood sometimes. They would do that.
When you cut your arm, you kind of put your mouth to it real quick.
I've never sucked my arm.
The truth is, it kind of stems back to the time of the Talmud, and there was a lot of influence in Greek medicine. And Greek medicine believed that if blood was, like, sort of sitting there, it would be what we would cause an infection. So they actually believed, our rabbis in Judaism, believed that if you left it there and you didn't do this process, the child was in life-threatening danger.
Got it.
And so we sort of keep it sort of as a tradition now, but those who are sort of in the know and know that it can cause death to children if you do it in that way because they can get herpes, do it with either a tube or with just gauze. That's what we do.
Yeah, I was going to say, make sure that the child is safe. It is 2017, and for probably about 100 years now, we've had like antibiotic ointment, gauze. I mean,
right.
I think it's time to move on from that tradition.
Because Josh saw this bris, and you know, Josh saw this child who was essentially served on a silver platter to the Moyle, right. and the Moyle, I think Josh, you said, was saying, hey, he's crying because he's hungry, he might be a little frightened of his surroundings, and it seemed like the Moyle was trying to convince himself more than everybody else,
that,
hey, the kid ain't going to feel nothing. What do you use, Rabbi Leiter, to soothe the area? We heard something about a simple syrup?
Correct. So there are two things that people tend to use. One, I do use it, and the other, I do not. Some people use a topical cream, so sort of like a numbing cream.
Yep.
And the problem is that you don't know, it's never been tested on children. And the problem is it can cause inflammation, and then the bris can't be on the eighth day, and that's really important to Mohalim and to the Jewish people. So that's something which I don't use. But the other thing which has been tested here actually by the leading doctor on science versus Jewish law, he says the number one thing for a child at 8 days is sugar water, and that's the best thing you can give them. And
do you apply it directly to the site?
No, they.
No. This is ingested. Orally. It's, they eat it
like a hummingbird.
So you drink sugar like water, and it makes it a little more. It makes it less painful. I'm trying to get the antiseptic or what am I saying?
Correct.
The numbing qualities
Correct.
Of this. Okay.
Right, and the truth is that process, they say, is actually better than giving them Novocaine at 8 days.
Mike Anderson.
Believe it or not.
I'm wondering, Rabbi, what would you say to the people that are against circumcision and claim that it reduces sexual pleasure?
It's a very good question, and I've gotten it many a times from my students, from people who I work with. There's a lot of people are concerned about that issue.
Because that's the most important thing.
For sure. I would say that that's the most important thing to the people who are anti-circumcision, for sure. And I think what I usually say is there's no doubt that there's going to be a loss of some sensation, I think. I mean, you're losing skin, so there has to be some loss in sensation. But on the one side, you have a lot in the Jewish tradition that talks about tailoring one's appetites. Right, we don't eat everything under the sun. Right, we don't eat pig. We don't eat right. So these things we don't do. And so one of the things is tailoring the appetite. That's one argument I usually go with. The other side of it is that, I mean, this might take you off in a direction that I'm not sure you want to go. But they actually those that were anti Brit Milan, anti circumcision, leaked something from the Pediatric Association a couple of months ago. I get this because I get circumcision,
Damn.
You know, Google alert.
Deep in the game.
And deep in the game. And so this thing which they leaked talked about how finally the Pediatric Association of America has admitted that there's a loss of sensation.
See?
And they felt like, they got them. They got them. That's what they felt like.
So why do I finish so quickly still?
This is not my issue. This is definitely more your issue.
I need answers, Rabbi.
So that's a deep-seated problem, maybe psychological. I don't know. But so what's interesting is if you listen to the audio, which goes with this article, the audio has a doctor talking about how men, when he was, I think he was in Vietnam, he was a doctor in the Army, they used to line up to get circumcision. They all wanted it because of what you just said, because it would help them last longer. And he said, that means that there's actually an increase in sexual satisfaction with getting a circumcision.
There you go, Mike.
And somebody from the other side raises his hand and says, wait, there's a loss of sensation. How could there possibly be an increase in sexual satisfaction? And the guy sort of, it was like they weren't talking to each other. The guy, the doctor was like, because his wife is getting more pleasure as well.
Whoa. Well, we do have to wrap up. But no, that's fine. Thank you for the call
all the way from
Jerusalem.
So cool. We appreciate the insight,
Rabbi Hayum Leiter. And you know, how many? Like, just real quickly, like how many alerts do you get a day on circumcision? I mean, is it like 1,000? I'm just very curious.
It's not 1,000, but I would say that on an average day, I could get 4 to 10 things coming across the desk.
All right. Well, you got one of ours. It's up at 98online.com. We talked circumcision yesterday. You can see the video there. He saw, he got an alert on his phone, reached out to Mike. He called us all the way from Jerusalem. Hayum? Hayum?
You got it. That'll work. That'll work.
There you go. Hayum Leiter.
All right. Thank you so much, man. We appreciate you checking in.